was it summer?
Yeah, I missed the summer.
Yes?
Yeah. My wife's working, and so I'm working. Mm-hmm. When I go back tomorrow, we have a house on Fire Island.
Yes, I was there.
Yeah.
Once.
Perfect.
Yes.
So I go there, and she's at the house right now, so.
Mm-hmm.
So I have my vacation then.
Uh-huh. Yeah, just for now.
This exhibition was made originally in 1991, so it's 25 years old. So it's not a new work. And I made it when I was living in Paris. And so I was in crisis about my work. And I was reading a lot of books. I was reading Barnett Newman. I was looking for inspiration. I was looking for ways of thinking, new ways of thinking. And Malevich seemed to be this really significant moment of a cut between old art and new art, the beginning of new art, mm-hmm. the beginning of a new world. And he wasn't concerned about the pictures of some things. He was more concerned with what something felt like, At the same time, Picasso was doing the same thing. He was doing, you know, paintings that didn't look representational, but they looked like what they felt like. So I thought it was really interesting to kind of try to understand that.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, the world was coming apart. The Soviet Union was falling. You know, it was the United States was invading Iraq. So there were lots of things in conflict. So these pieces are based off of Malevich, but they're also pieces that are in conflict. The surface is really in conflict. The surface is like battlefields,
mm-hmm.
you know. And so in that sense, I would think of him as, Malevich said that he was trying to find zero.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that was a really interesting idea. I mean, I found it very inspirational, so.
Yes. You are here in Düsseldorf. Düsseldorf is a town of zero.
Yeah, I know, I know.
Are you fascinated by zero art?
No.
Did zero inspire his drawings?
No.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I know the work, and I admire the work, especially mm-hmm. the man with the nails.
Yes, Uecker.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I think he's great. Yes. I think I saw his show last time I was here.
Yes.
I think it was really great.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very jealous of that work. I think it's really mm-hmm. great. No, I think Zero owes a lot to Malevich. I mean, we all owe, all modern artists owe a great deal of debt mm-hmm. to Malevich. I mean, mm-hmm. in that sense, I think it's really important. So, I mean, but Malevich specifically talked about Zero.
Yeah.
The irony is that these pieces are actually, their titles on the backs of the paintings are 1, 2, and 3. So there is no Zero actually.
Yes.
The square is 1, the cross is 2, and circle is 3. So. I think it's funny. I mean, I knew there would be, I was asking for trouble to do, this is like Zero Town.
Yes, yeah, yes.
I know, I thought it was kind of funny.
Uh-huh.
But.
Mm-hmm. Did you create your artwork in black and white? Looking like photos, but they are drawings. Doing with charcoal. Or why only black and white?
Well, I did work in color in the 80s. There's a whole body of work of mine that people have forgotten. I worked in black and white in the beginning of the 80s, and then from like the middle of the 80s to the end of the 80s, there's lots of work that's color. I think the reason why I work in black and white now is I think that maybe black and white is the closest thing to truth for me. I think it's highly abstract. I also grew up with television that was black and white.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have a color television until I was like,
uh-huh.
till I was maybe 18. So, I mean, the irony is, yeah, I mean, when I was growing up, the magazines that you would see, you would get like Life magazine or, you know, the news magazines, the color photography was always like the movie stars mm-hmm. or the fashion shoots, but the black and white photographs were always the photographs of the Vietnam War or the devastation from a hurricane.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It always seemed like journalistic photography, which was supposed to be the truth, was really interesting to me. So, and the charcoal gives the capacity to kind of evoke images that look photographic, but they're not photographic. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, so you have photography, you have traditional representation, and you have modern abstraction. I think I exist somewhere in the middle, so
mm-hmm.
maybe I translate photographs.
Yeah. Another question is, you said once art is a long distance run. Is this your advice for young artists?
Absolutely. 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 That's the best thing I can say to young artists, because so many young artists are so worried about having galleries and shows and things like that. We're not like athletes that have a limited window when we can be good. You know, after 35, you know, as an athlete, it's hard for you to compete. But
mm-hmm.
as an artist, you know, I think I'm 62 now, and I think I'm making the best work I've made in my life. And I don't think I think patience is really, I mean, I was very lucky to get a lot of success when I was younger,
mm-hmm.
but
yes.
I also lost it at mm-hmm. a certain point because then I had to rebuild it. So it's a different game, I think. The problem is with success as an artist is like, I never thought I would make money.
Mm-hmm.
I had no choice. I had to make my work. I drove a taxi. I worked in a factory. I didn't think maybe I would have to teach. That would be the worst job I'd have to have. But,
mm-hmm.
but.
Yes, and then the question is very important after your answer. People complain about money in the art world, as Jeff Koons and those kind of people. What do you think about money in the art world?
What do you think about money in the fucking real world? What do you think about all these people that have billions and billions of fucking dollars? I mean, it's really, it's like, I mean, it's funny that they, you think about these people that have billions of dollars.
Yes.
From the people in Qatar and Abu Dhabi to the Americans, America has more billionaires than any country in the world. I mean, artists making money, there's nothing wrong with it. We steal from rich people. We redistribute the wealth, maybe. I don't know how to, you know, the thing is, the irony is you're dealing with a situation where I'm part of the generation that started to make money. Mm-hmm. But the generation that came after me have made much more money. So mm-hmm. I'm part of the original sin in a lot of people's,
yes.
I have like the stain of original sin. But the thing is that I think people who buy the art, I think a lot of people are very confused as to what art becomes, has the capacity to be, to represent more than what it says in the bank. Mm-hmm. It's an index of desire. It can evoke that. But I think the thing about the money in the art world is, I mean, I think Jeff Koons is the artist the people who buy Jeff Koons deserve. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's pretty simple. It's like they want, it's kind of like, it's a kind of fashionable thing in that sense. I'm sorry, I get kind of like, the thing about money is really...
Yes, but the people now very concerned about when Sotheby's or Christie's are doing.
Well, the art market is very, it's as far as it's a business, there are no controls in it. People can manipulate the prices.
Yes.
You want to believe that somehow there is some kind of like truth and honesty. That's why there are curators and art historians and critics and things like that. You hope somehow there will be some critical criteria that will supersede. I mean, people can manipulate prices, of course they can.
Yes.
But you know, mm-hmm. I mean, I just, it's hard to say. I mean, I feel very lucky that I can do what I can do. I mean, you know, but I would be doing it anyway if I wasn't making money. Mm-hmm. Either that or I would be robbing you, one or the other. No. I would be stealing his camera.
Yes.
And selling it. You have a nice watch.
This was very interesting for me that you are using the internet to search for images that you then modify to become drawings.
Well, I just use them as source images. Rawa!
Who is this guy?
1 minute, but hello, Karatina.
Keep it out.
Uh-huh.
It involves the difference about cinema is the success of cinema is based upon a lot of people going to see the movie.
Yeah.
Art is not quite, you have a few people that can make you successful. It's kind of complicated, but the thing that after making movies, the problem that I had was that there were people telling me what to do and I couldn't do it.
Are you involved in German politics or things going on in Germany?
Can't avoid it. It's like German. It's interesting, you have a combination that of one sense, historically, this may sound really terrible, but Germany lost the war, but in a weird way they won the war. They're the most successful country in Europe, but they also have to deal with the immigrants with guilt. So you have this really weird combination of incredible success and great guilt. But I think the guilt is a really great thing that Germany tries to deal with the sins of their fathers. America doesn't do this. This is this issue of racial problems in the United States. The United States does not realize that what we did for 400 years, you know, with slaves, they don't want to acknowledge it doesn't exist. And now all this stuff is happening. But now you have this problem with immigrants. I mean, you turn the news on, it's like...
Yes,
and Germany is trying... And now I saw the man from Hungary talking about how... none of the people want to come to Hungary or Poland or Czechoslovakia. Yeah. They all want to go to Germany. Yeah. Of course they want to go to Germany because Germany is the best place to go. No, who the fuck wants to go to, you know, Hungary? I mean, it's horrible. Yeah. But so politically, Europe is a really interesting place right now because it's becoming more and more like America, except the biggest difference is America is not based upon a race or a nationality or a tribe. It's based more like on a sports team, which is a problem in itself. But because what do sports teams do? What's the goal of a sports team? To win. And that's, America doesn't think so much. Anyway, I think what's good.
Yes, thank you.
What
okay. It was nice. Thank you.
Do you know thank you very much.
Wenn das Reinhardt auch nicht.